Right, totally right.
Night school?
I don't know what to do. But think about the money. You have that kind of money.
Yes, as I grew older. Wealth is obscene in the young. It stunts ambition.
But what about security?
What is this mania for security? What's the worst that can happen?
That I do, Hamlet, and Gary's right. No one will hire me. And pretty soon I found myself laying in the gutter wearing nothing but rags and nowhere to go.
Shouldn't every evening end that way?
Why am I talking to you? And it's not just about the money. I'm not that superficial. It's the fame. Do you know how many people watch Night School, even if it's a ball?
Of course. There is fame in that sort of work. You may be admired, lusted after. You may acquire all the attributes of a well-marketed detergent. But there is fame, mere celebrity. And there is glory. Do you appreciate the difference?
Of course. Fame pays better. Fame has speech for puppet. Fame is bodyguards.
Glory. Only an audience.
Yes, but that audience has changed. Don't you think if Shakespeare were alive right now, he'd be writing normally?
Excuse me?
You know, wouldn't the character say, how are you doing, instead of, how dost thou, my liege?
Liege?
And what's a farmer? Okay, it's fear not to be. Now he's talking about suicide, right? He talks about how awful life is and the whips and scorns of time.
Correct.
And he says, why should anyone put up with all this, when he himself might his quietest make with a bare bodkin? Quietest?
Bodkin? Quietest means death. A bodkin is a dagger.
Then why can't... Well, okay, wait. There's this next line. Who would Bartle spare?
A Bartle is a burger. Any burger.
Why can't I just say, instead of... Why put up with all this? Just stab yourself and try to, instead of dragging your fartles around.
Angels and ministers of grace, defend us. Tell me, you love Shakespeare. If Los Angeles is so good, why did you audition?
Because my agent made me. Because Deirdre loves him. Because they asked me.
Because they asked me.
Because somewhere, someone thought that maybe, just maybe I didn't have to be Jim Corbett, rookie surgeon for the rest of my life. On TV, no one cared if I was talented. I had the right twinkle, the demographic appeal. And after a while, I began to think that's all I had. That if I didn't show up, they'd just use the poster. And then I came to New York, and someone said, wait, maybe Andy Rowley could do Shakespeare. On stage, say those lines.
Act.
Yes, but they were wrong. And I know I belong on TV. And it's not a crime. But I'm sorry I got you down here. And I'm sure that if you can go back and talk to whoever, you can get this whole Hamlet deal canceled. Because I'm really tired. And my girlfriend won't see me. And I'm afraid my agent is really ill, and she refuses to discuss it. So if you just please leave, I'd appreciate it.
Can you believe that you're the first performer to ever experience such misgivings? Can you possibly believe that every prospective Hamlet did not tremble and pale in bolt? Hamlet will change you, Andrew. Make no mistake. And the deal is determined, cannot be canceled. I cannot return until you have fulfilled your destiny. You approach a crossroads, and a decision must be made. What are you to be? Artist or lunchbox?
Stop it! You are no longer Jim Corbett. Get out!
And you are not yet sensitive, my son!
You don't know that!
Or Hamlet, no!
Right!
To be dashing and bold and vengeful. Well, I'm a liberal.
month.
Thank you.
imagines herself Ophelia. She shall win or drown.
We have accomplished much.
Vocal assurance.
Physical technique.
Even, dare I say it, an appreciation of the text.
Indeed, our achievement is twofold. Not only do I reveal the flesh, for the first time, I have finished it.
Welcome, Gallenberg, to the Royal Order of Athens.
The elite.
The august.
Princes and players.
Do not step, we strive. Do not speak,
we beseech.
We respect.
We roar!
Brother Hamlet,
spare me.
The moment is not. I lay my rightful heir. Kneel, Gallenberg. I hereby dub thee, Prince Hamlet, of all Lower Manhattan. You shall henceforth be known as the greatest American Hamlet.
Of all time?
Of your generation.
Of my generation?
And why not?
It's just, I keep thinking, tonight.
Of course, the performance, minutes from now.
No, I'm fine. Hamlet.
Whoa.
Hamlet's
glory.
Glory!
Shakespeare!
Shakespeare!
Blind unspeakable terror!
That's it!
Of course you'll tremble, and for the noblest of reasons. The role, the moment, the test.
Come with me, be there.
I cannot. No.
There must be some ancient secret of the Hamlets, something you've been saving.
Of course. Speak the speech, I pray, as I pronounced it to you, tripping on the tongue. But if you mount, as many of our players do, I had as lief the town crier spoke my lines. Nor do not saw the air too much of your hand thus, but use all gently, for in the very torrent, tempest, and as I may say, whirlwind of your passion, you must acquire and beget a temperance that may give it smoothness. Be not too tame, either. Let your own discretion be your truth. Suit the action to the word to the action. With this special observance that you overstep not the modesty of nature, for anything so overdone is for the purpose of play, whose end, both at the first and now, was and is to hold us to a mirror up to nature. Now, this overdone come tardy off. Now, though it make the unskillful laugh, cannot but make the judicious degree. Go, make you ready.
I don't think so.
Go, make you ready. It's all there, in the text, at your service.
I can't do that, what you just did. Who do you think I am?
Andrew, your fear has pissed me. My open mouth, good Lord.
But you were a Barrymore.
Barrymore? I was a light comedian, attempting Olympus. There was a family reputation, not about my neck. Before the curtain rose, I sat on the edge of the stage, in darkness, paralyzed with fear.
You weren't some TV clown. You were still doing theater.
Do not overestimate the form. Would you like the titles of my boulevard triumphs? The Fortune Hunter, Claire de Lune, Princess Zinzin.
But what if Gary's right? What if the critics hate me?
Ugh, newspapers.
What if I hate you?
You've prepared for this evening.
But when you played Hamlet, you spent 6 months in the countryside, just learning the role.
You have been diligent.
Yeah, 6 weeks? Come on, it's tonight. My friends and family are going to be there. People who saw me in my second grade school play and are expecting improvement. And Deirdre.
She'll adore.
It's not automatic. Deirdre wants... She's waiting for someone legendary, a hero. What if that doesn't happen? What if I disappoint her?
Impossible.
Up till now, I've been plugging away, trying to be like you, trying to be Hamlet. But now...
Andrew, this is not your first opening night. Your panic, your doubt, this is all to be expected.
This isn't just stage fright. This is something else.
What?
Common sense. I had this idea that I could come to New York and prove this ridiculous point to everyone, to myself.
Instant actor, just add Shakespeare.
I don't think it works that way.
And why not?
Because tonight, I'm going to be on that stage with actors, people who know what they're doing. Jesus, why did I listen to you? I can bail out in LA right now, making a fortune. It pants!
what you like? Is that what I taught you?
That's what I know.
Enough! You're unbearable, Brack. Your sniveling is a disgrace. The words of Shakespeare, be worthy. The role of Hamlet, be great.
Oh, come off it.
What?
Listen to yourself.
Excuse me.
After you played Hamlet, you left the theater.
Unimportant.
I read about it. After 101 performances, you went right to Hollywood.
For a time.
For the rest of your life.
That is my affair.
You had a mansion in Beverly Hills with a yacht. How many wives?
Quite a few.
You made movie after movie.
Some of them classics.
Most of them garbage.
Yes. And after a time, I even had trouble with those. There was a day on a set when the camera rolled. I couldn't remember a line, not a word, not a speech, take after take. And everyone was more than kind. And words were scribbled on shirt sleeves and cardboard held just out of camera range. But I knew. I knew instantly. I could never go back on stage.
To John Barrymore, the great classical actor, example to us all.
The hopeless, unemployable nut, the off-color joke. Yes, I meant to. You're quite right. You can't imagine the life I led. I was a movie star. Do you know what that means? My face, 5 stories high and 6 years wide. But before all that, in my pride, I faced the trap. I accepted a role so insanely complex that any attempt is only that, an attempt. And I stood in front of a crowd, fully prepared to dismiss, to deride, and to depart. And I shoot. I knew. And I said, yes, you will stay. And yes, you will remember. And for those sacred evenings, there was no shame. I used all the time, every ounce of gall. I was John Barrymore. I played Hamlet. Have you?
Yeah? All right, I'm coming.
Scoutmaster?
Excuse me.
Rally's a big boy.
So what do you want? Why do you stay?
I am like anyone else. I've come to see Barrymore.
A sideshow.
A three-ring circus. A true oddity. A movie star and a Danish prince. A womanizer, but never a beast. A drunkard, but at least until recently never bore. I hope for one last encounter, an encore. But that was long ago. Perhaps I remember incorrectly. I will go.
Lily.
Yes?
Will he be all right? And
who can say?
Have I helped him in any way?
Ask him when he returns. Any more questions?
Just one. Your husband. Is he well?
I hope not. We are divorced. You renamed the lawsuit.
Divorced? One last encounter.
Or 9 months later, hundreds of unexpected babies would be born, laughing hysterically.
costume?
Once. Two guys with a knife. I just said, look at me, guys. What do you want? A doubloon? A farthing? Then they recognized me from TV. Wrong show.
I mean, get walking.
What's going on around here? It's 7 a.m. Yeah? Come on up.
It's Gary.
Gary. That Malibu cloud of ozone, that cultural academy, night school, is that what you're doing?
I guess we'll find out.
Here's to all the money you can make, and all the pride that you can swallow. Why don't you join me, Andrew?
This is very good champagne.
And after all, you can afford it.
Lucky dog.
Hey, Hamlet, big guy, where were you last night? You missed it.
Look, but I got the papers.
Where did you already see him?
No.
Well, let's have a look. Aren't you curious?
There is something about someone who brings the papers with glee.
Shouldn't you be putting?
No, let me. An uninteresting attempt. If Mr. Robbie is to seriously consider a career on the boards, blah, blah, blah. Find supporting guys. DDD. And remember, it's free.
Not bad. Well, you got TV lightweight, but that's not so terrible, huh?
Personally, I thought you were terrific.
Like I could tell.
Gary.
Andy, I warned you. I said, it's not for you.
Hey, you learned, right?
In front of all those people? Shuffling all those feet?
I was there.
Okay, enough about that. I wanted to see before I took off, so I could call the network. Start pre-production. Are we on? All systems go? Wait, I know you're going to say yes, but let me polish the parts, you know, tickle the tree.
Gary, cut it. What's the offer?
The money. It's a feeding present. The first season, 24 episodes, guaranteed.
$3 million.
Even if it's a dud, it's enough to breathe, lay back. A house, houses, cars, no for your folks. For all they've done. Or if you hate them, run them out, the money's there. And if the show hits, okay, you're tied up for a few years, but hey, triples, quadruples, pictures. One day you wake up, and whatever happens, you're rich. Something goes wrong, something breaks. It's not so bad. It's never going to be so bad. Why? You're rich. It's like I say, the rich are different from you to me because they're rich. On the other hand, I'm just blowing smoke here. Pretend you're out of your mind. You say no. You make around here, the theater, no complaints. And in a few years, here you are. No offense. Another out of work action. Not so young, not so at work. Heavyweight champion. Sorry, Major D. But hey, you can work off the words. Chicago, it's a basement. It's the middle of July. I'm just folding chairs, Andy. I'm not trying to scare you, I'm just doing my job as a lead.
$3 million,
plus all expenses and personal staff. Folding chairs, Andy. Hold them up after every show. Hey, he's the hall. And hey, boy, are we on?
24 episodes. Full season. Am I in? Am I out of commitment?
You're tight.
No.
What no? No, you don't like the figures? No, you don't like the time slot?
No, Gary. Just no.
You don't get it. In LA, there is no no. You don't like it. Yes means sure unless they get a better offer, and no means yes with more money?
No, Gary. This is a New York no. A surgical no. A final terminal.
No, maybe.
Gary, it's like, would you be interested in doing a documentary for PBS on aspirin?
Talk says.
No.
Andy, you're saying this now, but what about tomorrow, the next day, when the bills start coming in, when you're flying coach?
I'm sorry.
Andy, think about me. Think about all the money I can make on this. Don't be selfish.
Have pity, Andrew. He's begging.
This is all your fault. You made him do this Hamlet crap.
Me? I am even seamanship. I was at home watching television. I am married.
What happened here, Andy? What am I going to tell the network?
Tell them, who needs Andy Robbins? Done with us.
That's good. That's great. Who can I get?
Gary!
$3 million? When would you be?
Well.
Here?
Babe, in the park.
We're going to miss the plane.
Felicia?
Hi, hon.
Andy, I got to make some calls, you know, damage control.
In the kitchen.
Honey, what can I say? Last night, were you terrific or what? I mean, the part I saw.
The part you saw?
Well, I caught the first act. You were so confused. But at intermission, I got thirsty. And Gary has a bar in the limo. And, well, one thing led to another. And I'm sorry.
The two of you?
Perfection.
Yeah, and all thanks to you and Shakespeare.
So you only saw one act. The both of you.
Honey, I'm sorry. What can I say? How did it end?
Felicia, are you going with Gary?
Yeah, to LA, long weekend. This is a great place. I
slam you in a cage, you're making some money.
Aren't you flying somewhere?
We'll call you.
From the plane, buddy. And Andy, this theater thing, we'll beat it together.
Worse and worse, totally drowning. Then I thought, all my questions are answered. I'm not here. or not to be? That is the question. Whether it is nobler in the mind to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune, or to take arms against a sea of troubles, and by opposing envy. And I finish the speech, and I look out, and there's the kid. He's listening. The whole audience, complete silence, total focus. And it lasts about 10 more seconds, then I was back in town. But for that one little bit, that one moment, I had it. I was Hamlet.
There it is, the glory of Shakespeare.
Yes, and I love this apartment, because once upon a time, you lived here. I mean, it's like a stage. It's like a theater.
Brother Hamlet.
Blair King. Stay. Teach me.
I cannot. You've already learned all that is important. You've tasted glory. Now, reach sky. Surprise everyone. And Andrew, this I promise you. One day, you will play indoors. Now, I must go. You have a performance and a matinee.
Get out of here!
I'm on my way, but I have a parting request. I was unable to witness your debut, but I must see your bow.
My bow?
As I suspected.
What?
It is perfunctory. A bow should be theater incarnate. Start out in a daze. Still lost in the drama. Good Lord, is that an audience?